Now let's say I have been given an array again of size n. So till now, a few questions that we have seen, what was the technique involved over there? Computing something from prefix or suffix, okay? And that is going to help you. Remember this technique, you will get a lot of problems where this will be highly applicable. Let's say the array contains 1, 5, 2, 4 and 3, okay? And now let's say I have to rotate the array, okay? What is the meaning of right rotation of array? So when you rotate something, you rotate something by some units, let's say k units. So right rotating by one unit, it means that you pick the last element and you bring it to the front. So if you right rotate it by one unit, you will get 3, 1, 5, 2, 4, okay? Can anyone tell me that if I right rotate this by 3 units, what will I get? Yeah, that is right, 2, 4, 3, 1, 5. Because when you right rotate for the first time, 3 will come in the beginning, okay? When for the second time, then 4 will come in the beginning, and then 2 will come in the beginning. So you will basically end up getting 2, 4, 3, 1 and 5. So question is simple, that you have been given an array and you have been given an integer k, okay? And you can assume that this k will be greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so you have to perform the right rotation of this array by k units. So what is the most basic way to do this? Think of first rotating just by one unit. Yes, shifting. So if you have to right rotate by one unit, just one unit, can you do that? If you have to right rotate just by one unit, can you do that? That is very easily doable, right? So if let's say I had this array 1, 5, 2, 4, 3. To do the right rotation, you would want that this 4 comes here, 2 comes here, 5 comes here, 1 comes here, and this 3 goes here. So how can you easily do that? You can store this last number in a variable temp. Okay, and then for all the elements from here till here, let's say this is an index x, then from index x till index 0, what you can do is a of x plus 1 equals to a of x. So what will happen? This 4 will come here, okay? This 2 will come here, this 5 will come here, this 1 will come here. And now this element which you had stored here, you can copy this element here. So this is one unit right rotation. What will be the complexity of this one unit of right rotation? Order n. Now you can do this process for k times and right rotate by k units. Is that clear to everyone? If you do it for k times, your complexity will be order n into k. And this is your time complexity. And what is the space complexity? It will just be order 1 because you did not use any extra space. Now tell me one thing, if the value of k is greater than n, okay, if let's say the value of k is very large, like 10 raised to power 18, is there a need to rotate it those many times? No, because think of it in this way. If there is this element, what will happen if you rotate it by 5 units? Think, you have already rotated by 3 units. If you rotate it by 2 more units, will you end up getting the same array? Yes. If you rotate it by 6 units, will you end up getting the same array which you get by rotating by 1 unit? So there is a cyclic nature, isn't it? So can I say that rotating by k units is same as rotating by k modulus n units? Can I say that? Yeah. So you can take k mod n and you can rotate it those many times. Now k mod n will always be smaller than n, isn't it? It will, because modulus with n always produces you results between 0 to n minus 1. So maximum value of k that you get by performing k modulus n can be n. So it will be order n square. The time complexity will never be greater than n square. Is that clear to everyone? How it will never be greater than n square? Because you never rotate by more than k mod n times. Okay. Okay, can I do this question in just order n time if I allow you to use some extra space? I believe most of you should be able to do. It's an easy piece, by the way. So think of it in this way, that if this is your array, 1, 5, 2, 4, 3. And let's say I ask you to rotate by 3 units. Okay. One way is that if you have to rotate by 3 units, you can push this 1 over here. But pushing this 1 over here means changing this value to 1. But if you change this value to 1 in the same array, then this will get overridden. So how will you then change this? So that doesn't look good. So what you can do is, you can take a temporary array, and in the temporary array, what you can do is, if there is an element array I, where should it go? It should go to temp of what? At what index should it go? Should it go at I plus k? Can I say that? Yes, most of you are saying it should go to I plus k. And I think that makes sense. But can there be a problem? If the value of I is, let's say, 4, in that case, 4 plus 3 will be index out of bound if the size of temp array is kept as the same. So in that case, what would you want to do? You would want to locate it at temp of I plus k modulus n. So see, what will that ensure? It will put this one at 0 plus 3, which is 3, and 3 modulus 5 is index 3. So this comes over here, okay, which is true. Okay, now this goes to index 1 plus 3, which is 4. 4 modulus 5 is 4. So this comes over here. Now this will go at index 2 plus 3 modulus 5, which is 0. So it will bring it at this point. Similarly, 4 will be brought here, 3 will be brought here, and your job is done. So what you can do is, you can create a temporary array of size n, and then you can simply traverse this array. And then you can do temp of I plus k modulus n will be equal to a of I. And that's it. Your job gets done. And what will be the time complexity of this approach? It will just be order of n. And what will be the space complexity? Space complexity will also be order n, because you are ending an extra array.